Today we will be having phase and frequency followers discussed in our 36th lecture. Let us consider what we did in the last lecture. We had sine wave generators and function generators discussed in the last lecture. Sine wave generators were blocks which were simulating second order differential equation with the first order coefficient being 0, or in fact it has to be negative in order that it is self starting, so that the sine wave can start from a minimal noise pickup and grow into the sine wave of the required frequency at a given amplitude, at which point of time the coefficient of the first order should go to 0 at the exactly the given amplitude of oscillation that is required by us. So this requires amplitude stabilization scheme or AGC, so that the gain of the amplifier can be appropriately adjusted so as to make the amplitude take on the required value. Function generator on the other hand is a simpler solution to obtaining stable amplitude of oscillation, square wave and triangular wave, which can be converted to a sine wave. Again, the voltage controlled oscillators made out of sine wave generators require an amplitude stabilization scheme, which is a control circuit for precision amplitude stabilization with the least amount of distortion coming into picture in the oscillating waveform. Whereas a function generator needs just one multiplier as against the two multipliers required for a sine wave voltage control oscillator, and therefore most of the time it is the function generator circuit that is normally used as voltage controlled oscillator. FM generator and FSK generator can be nothing but the VCOs, where FM is equal to the carrier frequency plus delta omega d sin omega m t, so that DC which generates the carrier and the frequency deviation delta omega d sin omega m t is the modulating frequency at the input of the VCO in order in addition to the DC. So that if you apply a DC with a modulating frequency in series with it at the input of a VCO, one generates FM. The DC corresponds to the VC omega C, and the modulating frequency amplitude causes the frequency deviation delta omega D. The proportionality constant, okay, which converts voltage to frequency is the KVCO, that is the change of output frequency as control voltage is changed. It is expressed in terms of radians per second per volt or in terms of hertz per volt. And FSK, it is nothing but a digital word input done with the DC over it, so that the frequency of shift is changing from omega c plus delta omega d to omega c minus delta omega d as ones and zero streams keep coming and modulating the carrier. So inverse function generation using VCO in a frequency locked loop, feedback loop, VCO comes in and input is a frequency, and the frequency detector is put at the front end, that forms what is called frequency locked loop. Obviously a VCO converts voltage to frequency, whereas VCO put in a feedback loop converts frequency to voltage, inverse function. So, we are discussing therefore later on the FLL, okay, in that form with VCO in a feedback loop. So, in the today's lecture, we will be starting with PLL, the phase lock loop. So, phase and frequency followers we call them, just like voltage and current followers. We have discussed this already in the analog systems of usefulness in current day signal processing. So, input is an AC signal Vp sin omega t, output is to be Vp dash sin omega t plus phi, where phi is the phase shift between input and output. This is fixed by the designer. It could be 90 degrees, 60 degrees, 45 degrees, 120 degrees, anything that we desire, okay. So, this is fixed. How to build a circuit with this kind of phase shift at any frequency is our task. Now, this was what was proposed earlier for this phase follower. Phi I is the input, phi naught is the output, and this phi I minus phi naught is what is fed in the error detector. So, error detector output is going to convert the phase difference to voltage. So, this is K1. This will call it as KPD, phase detector. So, later on we see that this phase to voltage conversion is done by a phase detector whose input is a phase difference, output is a DC, V average. So, this is nothing but the sensitivity of the phase to voltage converter, which is delta Vc by delta phi. And voltage to phase converter, so that this point we have generated an output phase from a voltage. So, what this block is something that we will again discuss. So, K2 is nothing but KVCP, voltage to phase converter, VCP, voltage controlled phase generator, we will call it voltage controlled phase generator. So, again KVCP, here this is nothing but delta phi naught by delta Vc. Therefore, is nothing but KPD into KVCP, that is the DC loop gain. Where are the applications of this so called phase lock loop? These are used in fine tuning of filters, wherein we had already seen this topic, wherein what we had done was we had taken a filter, applied the input to the filter. So, we have, for example, if we just have, let us say, a low pass filter of second order, let us say we have put a buffer here. So, if this is Vi and this is R and this is C, R and C, this is a buffer, we get here Vi divided by 1 plus SCR squared. So, which generates a second order low pass output, and this output has a phase lag with respect to input. So, output phase therefore is going to be minus 2 tan inverse omega C R. S is replaced by j omega. So, we have this as minus 2 tan inverse omega C R. So, if you plot this, it will start with 0 phase and keeps on going up to pi minus pi, going through minus pi by 2 at omega equal to 1 by RC. Each of the network gives a phase shift of 45 degree. And if now these R and C or C can be varied with respect to a control voltage, then it becomes a voltage controlled phase generator. So, you can vary this R or C, okay, or both in order to change the phase. So, this is a simple voltage controlled phase generator. So, it can be therefore used for tuning filters. That means, we had used this information to tune a sort of universal active filter block exactly to the incoming frequency, at which the phase shift at the low pass filter output was adjusted to be pi by 2 exactly. And we have shown that at omega equal to omega naught equal to 1 over RC, the phase shift between input and output of the low pass filter is exactly pi by 2. That is the phase locking. So, creating quadrature signals needed for communication applications. So, this quadrature pi by 2 phase shift, these are needed normally in communication applications. Generation of multi phase signals independent of frequency, that is from single phase to, for example, 3 phase conversion. So, this can be easily done by shifting the phase independent of frequency to 120 degrees and minus 120 degrees. So, phase modulation, direct phase modulation, this is a circuit we can directly phase modulate, frequency remaining the same. Distortion and spectrum analyzer, we have described how it can be used for tuning on to fundamental and the harmonics, thereby being able to be used as distortion analyzer. That means, given a setup whose distortion is to be measured, you give the input a pure sine wave and take the output and feed it to a self-tuned filter, which will give the fundamental at its bandpass output and the rest of the harmonic at the notch output. So, the notch output RMS value directly gives you the percentage distortion, knowing the fundamental amplitude. PLL functioning. Input to the phase lock loop is phi I, which is the reference phase, which is taken to be 0. Output of concern is phi naught. So, that is fixed, let us say at pi by 2 or something like that, 60 degree, anything that you desire. Delta phi naught by delta phi I of such system is going to be k1 k2 by 1 plus k1 k2. This is gl by 1 plus gl. Okay. It is also equal to 1 by 1 plus 1 over the loop gain. It's 1 by 1 plus 1 over loop gain. This is the standard feedback system design that we have already discussed time and again, where GL is the negative feedback loop gain. It is negative feedback, that way it becomes 1 plus 1 over loop gain. Delta phi naught by delta phi I should be equal to 1. If the loop gain GL is much greater than 1, okay, we know that it is going to be a phase locked system. Okay. Now, what are these two blocks that we have used? To convert phase to voltage, a phase detector is used. This again we had discussed while discussing filter tuning. So, Vp sin omega t is one input, Vp dash sin omega t plus phi is the other input. omega is the frequency at which input is coming, 2 pi f. So this is the low pass filter. So Vp, Vp dash by 10 sin omega t plus phi is the output at this point. So we get this as Vp, Vp dash by 20 cos phi cos A minus B minus cos A plus B 2 omega t plus phi, out of which this is got rid of by the low pass filter. That means omega is much greater than 1 by RC. So if it is designed such that this is the case, that means RC has to be chosen to be much greater than 1 by omega. So if that is done, then we get this DC output Vp, Vp dash by 20 cos phi. And this, if you want the phase shift to be 90 degree, for example, this factor V average should be going to 0. That means cos phi should be 0. So phi is pi by 2. And K1 is KPD by 1 plus SCR, the low pass filter, okay. And KPD is delta V average by delta phi, which is minus Vp, Vp dash by 20 sin phi. So that is why this product is going to result in a negative feedback, okay, as far as the system is concerned, okay. KPD is maximum at phi is equal to pi by 2. So that is minus Vp, Vp dash by 20 and is 0 at phi equal to 0 and pi. This is to be noted particularly because it is gradually going to 0 from the maximum, the sensitivity. So 0 sensitivity means the loop, if at all this phase detector is put in a loop, the loop gets broken, okay. So loop gain equal to 0 can be controlled by this, by these two limits. That means that is the limit over which, right, loop gain much greater than 1 can be achieved only within this limit, right, because it is going to be 0 both at phi equal to 0 and pi, that is in between, okay. Hopefully GL is going to be much greater than 1. So that is the characteristic of the V average cos phi, and the sensitivity is going to be a sin phi characteristic, okay, minus sin phi. So it will be going to maximum, okay, at this point and then going to back to 0. So that is the sin phi characteristic, minus sin phi. So Vp dash by 20. In order to detect phase, a phase detector is effective only maybe somewhere within this region where this sensitivity into the other sensitivity make the loop gain much greater than 1. That means it is constrained to detect phase difference around pi by 2 by only a limited magnitude around this range. That is what is called the lock range of the phase lock loop, okay. Now it is also true that if this is resulting in negative feedback of the entire system, okay, this slope here being negative, okay, this one will result in positive feedback. That means a shift of phase by pi from this plus pi by 2 to minus pi by 2 changes the slope from negative to positive, okay. So what it means is delta V average by delta phi in this case is negative, whereas it is positive, okay, that is around pi by 2 phase shift coefficient, whereas delta V average by delta phi around minus pi by 2 is positive. Please remember this, because it can, if this is resulting in negative feedback, the other one, the operating range, results in positive feedback. That is shifting thing from, let us say that this is the minus pi by 2 may be a lag, okay. So, this may be the resulting in, let us say, negative feedback, then plus pi by 2 operating region will result in positive feedback and vice versa. Now, you can make the sensitivity high maximum and remain same as the maximum throughout by a simple technique of linearizing the phase detector. That can be done by putting two limiters, or these are called zero crossing detectors, which convert the sine wave at the input to a square wave. With amplitude, let us say Vp here, and the shifted wave, square wave, okay, with, let us say, shift of phi with Vp dash. Then what happens is multiplication results in this becoming Vp, Vp dash by 10, and changing from, let us say, when both are positive, negative, this is positive, or both are positive, it is positive. Okay. So, it changes from negative to positive in half the period of the original signal, okay, and then again changes from negative to positive in the other half. So, the 2 omega component is there. Apart from that, the average component corresponds to this, which is nothing but minus Vp, Vp dash by 10, that area, into phi, that is this area, negative area, plus the positive area Vp, Vp dash by 10 into pi minus phi. This is pi, so this is pi minus phi. So, the average becomes Vp, Vp dash by 10 into 1 minus 2 phi by pi, and it just becomes a linear phase detector. And KPD is constant throughout the operating range and from 0 to pi, which is minus Vp, Vp dash by 10 into 2 by pi. Differentiate this. This is nothing but delta V average by delta phi, which is what we have called as KPD. It is negative and remains constant. So, it is better to operate this around pi by 2, so that the dynamic range over which the locking functions, phase locking occurs or phase following occurs, is maximum of pi by 2 from pi by 2 going all the way up to 0, and again pi by 2 from pi by 2 going all the way up to pi. So, that is the range over which locking can take place, and beyond this it goes, if this is negative feedback, this will be positive. Again, if you shift it by pi, again it becomes positive feedback. So, if this is resulting in positive feedback, shift it by pi and it will become negative feedback. Shift the input by pi or the output by pi and feed it to the phase detector. So, this is the technique of negative feedback in this phase lock loop. So, this is going to be drawn here this way. Keeps on repeating, this is at pi by 2. This is the maximum Vp, Vp dash by 10, okay. And this should be the operating point, or this should be operating point, okay. So this is the phase detector which is linearized. Now this is the voltage control phase generator. So what is now happening is it is nothing but a low pass filter as demonstrated earlier. So let us say the low pass filter omega naught, which is 1 over RC, okay, is controlled by a voltage. Then d phi by dVc of the voltage control phase generator, which is the second block K2, okay, whose KVCP is what we are trying to now define, is going to be delta phi by delta VC. This is the phase generator output. This is the input, okay, which is coming to the phase lock loop, the phase detector also. So it is coming to this also. So that is going to result in delta phi by delta omega naught. This is characterized by the low pass filter, let us say, or high pass filter. So characteristic, and delta omega naught by delta VC is characterized by how we are changing the element R and C by means of a voltage. So it is a voltage control resistor or voltage control capacitor, or we will see later that multiplier, okay, feeding its output to a resistance or capacitance can act as a voltage controlled resistor or capacitor respectively. Such an arrangement is shown here. So here the polarity is minus plus, okay. So this is nothing but an inverting amplifier with this converting voltage to current Vi by R, and that is flowing through this Z, okay, and results in Z into Vi by R. So that will result in a transfer function V0 by Vi for one block as 1, because R, so it is 1 divided by 1 plus S C dash. C dash is C plus effect of C by 2. So C dash into R. So C dash is nothing but C shunted by C by 2 modified by VC divided by 10. So this is VC. So this output is VC if this is V0 1, VC V0 1 by 10. So the current in this is VC V0 1 by 10 into SC by 2. This into SC divided by 2. So this results in the capacitor appearing as, okay, C VC by 20. So that is the C dash. So omega naught is equal to 1 by C dash R for this low pass filter. So the other one also is exactly identical to this. So the transfer function is this squared, which results in a phase shift from here to here by an amount which is changing from 0 to pi minus pi, with that going to minus pi by 2 at omega naught equal to, or omega naught by omega i by omega naught equal to 1. Omega naught is equal to 1 over CR. So at omega equal to 1 over CR, the phase shift is pi by 2. So this is normalized frequency omega I by omega naught. Omega naught equal to 1 over CR. So now actually omega I, the incoming frequency, is fixed. What is changed in the voltage control phase generator is the omega naught, as decided by this. That is voltage controllable. So that is why this is a voltage control phase generator. So delta phi by delta VC is delta phi by delta omega naught, which can be evaluated from this. Okay, the phase shift is changing this way, 0 to minus pi going through minus pi by 2 at omega I equal to omega naught. What we are interested in as the variable here is not omega I, please remember, it is omega naught which is variable. That means if this is omega I by omega naught is x, omega I by omega naught is x with omega I as variable. Now omega naught as variable, it becomes 1 over x, okay. That is the plot is going to change its slope when you have omega naught as the variable as against omega I as the variable. Omega I being fixed, omega naught is changed by the control voltage. So this characteristic slope is going to change to let us say if this is negative, that will become positive this way. So this has to be borne in mind. So we have here these two blocks which are put, and the specific value of R equal to 1 k, C equal to 1 microfarad has been used, okay. This is 0.5 microfarad C by 2, and now the omega naught can be varied over a certain limit, okay, based on the saturation state of the op amp and the incoming input saturation state here. So let us assume that the multiplier is working only up to plus minus 10 volts. It is having Vx Vi by 10 as its output. So all these precision multipliers have been designed to work over the dynamic range of plus minus 10 volts. So in which case the capacitance C varies from C minus C by 2 to C dash, this is the range, okay, C plus C by 2. That means effectively C by 2 to 3 C by 2. That means omega naught changes over a range of 2 by RC to let us say 2/3 RC. So that is the lock range. As this is the highest frequency, this is the lowest frequency. So that is called the lock range of this phase lock loop. We have designed it such that this becomes the lock range, let us say, for the example chosen. Now you will find that input is not directly fed here. This introduces in the loop a negative sign. The phase detector itself, right, along with the phase generator, which is corresponding to delta, this amplifier is introducing negative sign. The rest of the block therefore has to introduce a positive sign so that it is overall negative feedback. That means it is converting the delta phi by delta Vc is nothing but delta phi by this is the phase generated here, delta omega naught into delta omega naught by delta Vc. So this has to be positive, okay. Delta omega naught by delta Vc here is omega naught is equal to 1 by RC into 1 plus Vc by 10. So we have delta omega naught by delta Vc negative. Okay, and therefore this has to be positive. That means delta phi by delta omega naught is delta omega naught by delta Vc is negative. So this has to be positive. Okay, this whole thing has to be positive. That means delta phi by delta omega naught has to be negative. So that is facilitated by changing the phase shift of this from 0 to pi here. That means this inverter simply changes the phase shift to pi so that the whole contribution due to the voltage to phase converter, okay, is going to be let us say, because the phase detector, okay, is going to give you a phase of KPD of negative value for increasing, let us say, frequency. The phase shift is negative, KPD is negative, then this whole thing has to be giving another negative value, okay, and that is done by this. So, overall the phase detector, okay, is going to give you a positive sign for delta phi by delta V c. So, this is thing, if this is negative, there can be this negative and this negative, this positive and this positive. So, these are the combinations. If this is positive, this has to be positive. If this is negative, this also has to be negative. So, that KVCF into KPD overall should be always positive, so that this one negative sign is taken care of, okay, in the negative feedback topology. So, Vp sin omega reference T is fed both to the phase detector as well as the voltage control phase generator. So, this is not VCF, it is VCP. Phase variation of the low pass filter as a function of omega, omega means omega I, that is what is plotted by us. It is this inverse of this, that is this characteristic which is going like this with positive slope, that is of interest because omega I is fixed and omega naught is variable. So, if you now plot this as omega I by omega naught, what is actually required is in omega naught by omega I plot, it will look like this. So, delta phi naught by delta phi I is going to be equal to 1 by 1 plus G L. 1 by 1 plus, what is G L here? 1 by G L. It's a mistake here. 1 by 1 plus 1 over G L as pointed out earlier in the earlier slides. And what is G L? G L is nothing but, it is negative KVCP into KPD, okay, KVCP KPD into 1 over, okay, S C dash R dash of the integrator. So, this 1 over G L now becomes 1 by 1 plus S C dash R dash divided by KVCP KPD. So, which is 1 by 1 plus S by bandwidth of the phase log. It is a first order system this way. If you now include the gain bandwidth product of the op amp, which is acting as an integrator, we know that the loop gain has to change from this to, okay, that 1 over S C dash R dash, which is the ideal transfer function of the integrator, gets modified, this we have seen earlier also, by additional phase error caused by the finite gain bandwidth product. So, this 1 plus S by G B comes into picture as a product here, 1 plus S by G B, which will make this 1 by 1 plus S by bandwidth plus S squared by gain bandwidth product into bandwidth of the phase lock load. So, this results in this system becoming a second order, and we can optimize this. If you make the bandwidth same as the gain bandwidth product of the op amp, then Q is equal to 1. So, that means there will be just in the transient response of this phase lock loop, there will be just one peak and it comes to steady state as phase is changed by a step suddenly from, right, the phase jumps from say phi 1 to phi 2. Then at the input, then the output characteristic of the phase will be just having just one peak. This is the optimum highest speed system. Rate of rise is maximum and simultaneously the number of ripples are minimized. Now that loop has been made with these values of resistors and capacitors. So you can see that when the control voltage is 0, no contribution of capacitor occurs due to C by 2. So omega naught is 1 by RC, which is R is 1k and C is 1 microfarad. So that frequency is 159 hertz, okay, and with the limiting values of Vc to plus minus 10 volts, the range has been obtained for locking of the system at 90 degree phase shift. So this is one frequency close to the positive saturation value. So at which point it is 100 hertz. So since omega naught is inversely proportional Vc, this is the minimum frequency on one side, okay, and when Vc is 0, it is 159 hertz, and when Vc is going negative, it is going to 200 hertz here as the input, okay, frequency is 200 hertz. Now you can see the control voltage is going negative. This is positive near saturation, this is negative but much below saturation. That means it can go still higher. 160 hertz, you can see the Vc is close to 0, 159 was the calculated value, and again the phase shift is exactly 90 degrees. And the amplitude, because it is phase locked, it is magnitude locked also. The amplitude, if the input remains the same, output amplitude also remains same for all frequencies, because omega CR is a constant, okay. So a phase lock loop is also a magnitude lock loop, okay. The range of input frequencies for which the specified phase locking occurs is now going to change from 2 by RC to 2 by 3 RC, that is 318 hertz to 106 hertz. We have seen it locking nicely from 200 hertz to 100 nearly about 100 hertz, right. Yes, it has gone over much above saturation here, yeah, above 10 volts, okay, that is why it has slightly changed, okay. So that is the reason Vc has gone above 10 volts, right. That is why it has gone all the way up to 100 hertz without any problem of locking. Okay, the phase modulation. This has been discussed in self-tuned filter. This was the filter that has been built for self-tuning action, and we have seen that whatever be the input frequency, the filter gets locked on to the incoming frequency. So if it is square wave, you get the fundamental at the band pass output, okay, here, and at the notch output you do not get anything. So that has been highlighted in this. For a specific incoming frequency, which is 2000 hertz, we see that it is very nearly, control voltage is very nearly settling at 0, okay, for the given values of R and C, and it's settling down to 0, and this is the bandpass output gradually growing and getting maximum. This is the notch output going to 0. So it has been self-tuned, tuned to 2000. Then what happens? Let us see. It is locked. This is the low pass output compared to the input, and you can see that it is having 90 degree phase shift. Low pass output. So again another frequency, that is 1000 hertz, the voltage on to negative from 0, some value. So it has got tuned to that incoming frequency of 1000, and you can see the notch output going to 0 once again. This is the effect of the second order system that has resulted in the control loop. okay, becoming second order. So you can see just one peak here. So it is having a Q equal to very nearly equal to 1. Okay. So this is the 90 degree phase shift for that frequency of 1000 hertz. This is the phase locking occurring at 90 degrees for the low pass filter output. So now we can go over to frequency followers. So what is a frequency follower? Please remember that in this particular case, right, if you change over from low pass to high pass, it will become positive feedback and it will not function, right. So one sign change occurs, right. So in this case of the circuit, please remember that R is varied, that means delta, what is that, omega naught by delta Vc is going to be positive, because it is R shunted by 0.8 R, okay, into 10 by Vc. When you put a multiplier, okay, oh sorry, it is this way, this is 0.8 R shunted by R into 10 by Vc. So the resistance that is varied is inversely proportional to Vc. That means omega naught is going to be directly proportional to Vc, is directly proportional to Vc. So delta omega naught by delta Vc is positive, unlike the previous case of phase lock loop where we had delta omega naught by delta Vc becoming negative because C was C Vc by 10. So that is the difference. That means actually this being positive, we have to have this delta phi by delta omega naught, okay, into this being positive in this particular case. We have to select it as positive so that overall loop gain is negative. So we have directly taken the output from the low pass filter and fed it to the of our universal active filter block, okay, and fed it to the integrator, which gives you a negative sign. So this conversion factor has to be positive. For negative feedback. Okay. Okay. So we have seen this, that we have now a frequency lock loop to discuss. And what is it? This is frequency to voltage converter, which is the same as phase detector. Now what I have to mention is, when we feed sin theta 1 into sin theta 2 to phase detector, it just takes theta 1 minus theta 2, okay, of cos and cos theta 1 plus theta 2. This is the overall phase, which is made up of omega t frequency plus the actual phase difference phi. So if frequencies are different, it can be omega 1 t plus phi, and this can be omega 2 t. So then this component becomes omega 1 minus omega 2 into t. Okay. So that plus phi. and this component becomes actually phi becomes meaningless because the change of phase, okay, is incorporated in change in frequency, difference in frequency. So we have this becoming omega 1 plus omega 2 into t. So if this is removed by the low pass filter, the low pass filter will correspond to this. So the same arrangement of phase detector with low pass filter is going to be sufficient for frequency detection at the input. So it won't know the difference. As far as K2 is concerned, so this K1 remains same as KPD. But K2 on the other hand now becomes voltage to frequency converter, which is nothing but a VCO. So it is an independent oscillator controlled by a voltage. So instead of KVCP, we have to use KVCO as the sensitivity factor. So where are these frequency locked loops used? These are popularly known as PLLs and are used in signal conditioning in repeater stations, okay. So what is done here is that the signal gets corrupted by the transmission line and gets distorted. It can be restored to higher power level by using a frequency follower. So a PLL as a frequency follower is used in repeater stations, in microwave, one microwave station to another microwave station, okay, several repeater stations are there for signal conditioning. That means improve the signal to noise ratio, right. So that is what is done simply by using a PLL and taking the output from the VCO, which is going to be frequency selective VC, and therefore it gets rid of the noise and power level can be improved. Signal power level, wanted signal power level can be improved. Generating stable carrier for and clock signals up to microwave frequencies is one of the most important uses of the PLL. FSK detection in modems. I told you that VCO put in a feedback loop results in inverse function. So FSK detection, okay, FSK generator is VCO and FSK detection is done in the PLL. And they are part of modems. Modulator means VCO, demodulator means PLL. FM detection, okay, and AM detection can also be done, okay, using this, just as FSK detection is done. AM detection, it can be removing the amplitude modulation by making it go through a limiter, and that can recover the carrier. And carrier, that recovered carrier, okay, shifted in phase by angle of pi by 2 is again multiplied by the incoming AM to give AM detection. We will see this application later. Clock recovery, obviously, right. So it can synchronize with the incoming clock if it is tuned properly. Precision speed control of motors. The time of voltage reference is over and time reference and frequency references are coming to be used more and more often than voltage or current as reference. Now phase detector as frequency detector. So Vp sin 2 omega 2 pi f t, Vp dash sin 2 pi f t plus phi now is replaced by Vp sin omega 1 t Vp dash sin omega 2 t as pointed out earlier. So this will hopefully give an output Vp dash by 20 cos omega 1 minus omega 2 t. the some component being eliminated by this low pass filter. That is omega 1 plus omega 2 should be much greater than 1 by RC. So, frequency by definition, this is very important fundamentally, omega is equal to delta phi by delta t, rate of change of phase is radian frequency. Output of the multiply being this sin omega I t sin omega naught t plus phi, you get this as cos omega I minus omega naught t, omega I plus omega naught t, okay. And delta phi naught by delta phi I is going to be 1 by 1 plus, okay, 1 by GL, okay. When GL is much greater than 1, then delta phi naught by delta phi I is equal to 1, this we had already shown in PLL. In which case delta phi naught by delta t divided by delta phi I by delta t also should be equal to 1. And therefore, what is delta phi naught by delta t is output frequency, absolute value, and delta phi I by delta t is absolute value of input frequency. Output frequency is exactly equal to incoming frequency. So, this is what is assumed while analyzing the PLL. Later on we will see, right, that output frequency should be always equal to input frequency if it is phase locked. So, that is why the frequency lock loop got its name as phase lock loop. Frequency locking, phase locking means frequency locking. The two frequencies are different. These are the basic building blocks. Let us see. Incoming frequency is applied to the phase detector, one input. The other input to the phase detector is one that gets the incoming frequency as the input and converts it into a suitable phase from the incoming frequency. So, the frequency remains the same as the incoming frequency, but phase is now controlled by VC. So, that is called a voltage control phase generator, and that gives the output here and the phase locking takes place. V reference if it is 0 and Ka need not be there, if these sensitivities are high enough the loop gain can be made high. So, you can just connect the output of the low pass filter directly to this to form a basic phase lock loop or frequency lock loop. Now, in this particular case that phase locking occurs for pi by 2, 90 degrees, the reference is 0. Same thing happens here, reference is 0, phase locking occurs at pi by 2, but output frequency is going to be same as incoming frequency. So, this is replaced by VCO with KVCO as its sensitivity factor. So, these are the other sensitivity factors here. So, that is FLL. So, this link from this to this is broken and it is VCP is replaced by VCO. That is the major difference. And what does this difference do to FLL? So, we will see this in the next class on FLL. So, that is the difference between the true PLL and the FLL. In conclusion, we have seen that we have to first understand the PLL, okay, as the true phase lock loop. It is primarily used for tuning filters, okay, or generating multi-phase signal from a single phase of any frequency. So, phase can be maintained absolutely constant, okay, and also used for phase modulation directly. Okay. The circuit doing phase modulation, this is a simple circuit. The next one discussed is a variant of the phase lock loop which is popularly called as PLL, but it is truly frequency lock loop. So, this frequency lock loop contains as a basic building block the phase detector and followed by the low pass filter and an amplifier to boost up the loop gain if necessary. Otherwise, it may not be necessary if the sensitivity factors themselves are pretty high. So this is fed to the VCO now, which is an independent oscillator controlled by a DC voltage at the input. The frequency of which is controlled by a DC voltage. It is this phase lock loop, which is called as FLL, that we are going to discuss in detail in the next class. Thank you very much.